One of the questions I get asked the most when doing a Teams deployment is, how to transfer Teams calls? Well, today I'll be showing you three different ways in which you can transfer a Teams call. I am Tian Kutzer, and this is In My Humble Opinion. So for this demo, I am using Teams to Teams calling, but this call scenario applies to both Teams to Teams calling and PSTN calling. Now, as you can see, I am currently in a call with James T. Kirk. You might know of him. And if you look at the top there, we have the ellipses or more options. Once you click on that, you will see that at the bottom, we have two transfer options within the call. Now firstly, we'll be looking at the transfer option. So once we click on that, it opens up a transfer call. Now in here we can type in the person we want to transfer the calls to. In this case, we'll transfer to Bones. Now you have an option there to select ring back if there is no answer, or you can just click transfer. Now this is a blind transfer. Now here you can also see that Bones at the moment is showing as away, and there he goes, he is now available. So you can also see the status of the person you're trying to transfer to. Now next to the transfer button is another option to transfer to voicemail. If you have PSTN calling, you will also be able to transfer to the user's mobile. So once you hit the transfer button, the call will then start transferring. As you can see, it's done there. Now I've started a new call back to James again to show you what happens when you decide to cancel a transfer. So we will hit the transfer button, and you'll see in the background that the call is automatically placed on hold. Now let's say I want to do a transfer to Bones, but I actually wanted to do a consultative transfer. When you cancel the transfer, the call stays on hold, and then you just have to hit resume to resume the call again. Once you do that, you will then have the options to transfer again. And again, once you click on consult transfer, the call will then be placed on hold. Again, you just search for the user you are after. Now you will see that the default option in Teams is chat. Now this is different to normal PABX systems, which normally would do voice consultative transfer. So you can either do chat, or if you hit the drop down button next to chat, you will still have the option to do voice audio transfer. In this scenario, we will click on chat and show you the chat window that opens. So now I've got a chat window directly open to Bones, and the call still placed on hold, and now I can just IM Bones to see whether he wants to accept the call. So I'll just type in there to see, say, hey, I have got this call for you. How would you like me to transfer the call? Now you'll see at the top of the window, you have a transfer option. So the options to transfer is directly within the call. Now if Bones maybe said, well, actually we need to transfer to someone else, you can add someone into this chat, or you can just go, yep, he's happy to take the call, so let's hit the transfer button. Now you'll see there's also a drop down menu next to transfer, and in this option again, if he goes, no, I'm busy, please send it to my voicemail, you have got this option. And again, if this is a PSTN call, you will also have the mobile option. If he goes, I can't take the call now, I'm heading out, but please do transfer it to my mobile. Now you will also be able to see when Bones starts replying, so you can see, okay, you've seen my message, yep, please do transfer, and away you go, and the call is transferred. There you have it. We've looked at the three different ways in which to transfer Teams call. Pretty simple, but might take some getting used to. Please don't forget to subscribe, like if you like the video, and we'll see you in the next instance of In My Humble Opinion. I am Tian Kutzer.